ونحن له مسلمون. This is a beautiful verse. In order to learn its meaning and what it signify, you need to stay tuned and hang around after this short break. Inshallah, we'll have a chance to explain what it means. So please stay tuned. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
سنعود بإذن الله.
ولتهنأ طيبة بمحمد نورا للأبيض والأسود. أقبل يا شهر محرم بشر بالجنة من أسلم من أسلم من أسلم. أقبل يا شهر محرم ذكرنا بالحدث الأعظم. أقبل يا شهر محرم.
الهجرة درس للأمة كشف القيوم به الأمة.
دعوة عامة تدعوكم قناة الرحمة للهجرة معها يوم الخميس القادم، هجرة إلى الله، هجرة عن المعاصي، في صحبة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. هيا نهاجر.
نوران القلب في اشتعال من خوف ربه ذي الجلال.
في استقبال العام الهجري الجديد في صحبة علماء الأمة، فضيلة الشيخ محمد حسين يعقوب، فضيلة الأستاذ الدكتور عبد الله شاكر، فضيلة الأستاذ الدكتور جمال المراكبي، فضيلة الشيخ مصطفى العدوي، فضيلة الأستاذ الدكتور طلعت عفيفي، فضيلة الشيخ سعد عرفات، فضيلة الشيخ مسعد أنور، فضيلة الأستاذ الدكتور شهاب الدين أبو زهو، الشيخ عبد الله كامل، والشيخ يوسف معاطي، مع ملهم العسوي. الهجرة غدا من 5:15 مساء، نحن في انتظاركم لنهاجر معا.
هذا الصديق يراقبه والشوق إليه غالبه.
البدر علينا من ثنيات الوداع، وجب الشكر علينا ما دعا لله داع.
عدنا بفضل الله.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back. With verse number 133 of the second chapter, Surah Al-Baqarah, in which Allah the Almighty confirms the fact that Islam was the religion of all the prophets before Muhammad, peace be upon him and upon all of them. The verse says, were you guys witnesses when death approached Ya'qub, Prophet Jacob, the father of the Israelites? By the way, Prophet Jacob have two names, a name which is Jacob and another name which is Israel, or Israel in Arabic, which means a servant of God. So the word Israel itself refers to Prophet Jacob, peace be upon him. And when we say the children of Israel, we refer to all the children of Prophet Jacob, including Prophet Joseph and his brother Benjamin, and the other brothers who tried to kidnap and kill or get rid of their brother Yusuf, peace be upon him. So now, Prophet Jacob was dying and death was approaching them. He gathered his children. أَمْ كُنْتُمْ شُهَدَاءَ إِذْ حَضَرَ يَعْقُوبَ الْمَوْتِ إِذْ قَالَ لِبَنِيهِ. Normally when somebody who's the head of a big family is afraid that he's gonna die, or he feels that he's approaching his end, he gathers his children, his family members, in order to pass on to them a wasiyah or a will. So Prophet Jacob, peace be upon him, gathered his children, his sons, and he said his wasiyah, his advice, his farewell advice to his children was, مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ بَعْدِي. So what are you going to worship after me? This is a very straightforward question. And the answer was as well very straightforward. They said, قالوا نعبد إلهك وإله آبائك إبراهيم وإسماعيل وإسحاق إلها واحدا ونحن له مسلمون. The son said to the father, definitely we are going to worship your God and the God of your fathers and forefathers, Prophet Abraham, Ishmael, Isaac. He is one God, and we're going to submit ourselves unto his will. So that indicates Jacob, Joseph, Benjamin, and all the children of Israel, and all the prophets and the kings who believed in Allah the Almighty, the children of Israel, were Muslims. وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُسْلِمُونَ. Then Allah the Almighty confirms also in a previous verse in the same chapter about Ibrahim alayhi salam, the father of all the prophets. Allah the Almighty says, وَمَنْ يَرْغَبُ عَنْ مِلَّةِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ إِلَّا مَنْ قَدْ سَفِهَ نَفْسَهُ. If you guys would like to follow the pure nature, the monotheism which Ibrahim, Prophet Abraham, used to follow, his belief, then it is Islam. And whoever turns away himself from his mission, from his belief, from monotheism, from the belief of Prophet Abraham, he befools himself. He is a foolish person. He's befooling himself. إِذْ قَالَ وَمَنْ يَرْغَبُ عَنْ مِلَّةِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ إِلَّا مَنْ سَفِهَ نَفْسَهُ وَلَقَدْ اصْطَفَيْنَاهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَإِنَّهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ لَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Allah the Almighty says that we have chosen Abraham to be a prophet in this life, and indeed in the hereafter he is one of the righteous ones. Why? إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ. When his Lord ordered him to submit himself unto him, to become a Muslim, to become a believer, to believe in monotheism. قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ. Then he submitted himself immediately to the will of Allah, لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, to the Lord of everything that exists. وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ وَيَعْقُوبُ. Then Prophet Abraham, then afterward Prophet Jacob, peace be upon all of them, have enjoined upon their children the same, to worship only Allah the Almighty, to submit themselves unto him, and not to take any partners to Allah in worship. From that we understand that it was indeed the mission of all the prophets, from Ibrahim alayhi salam to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam. From Prophet Nuh, who said to his people, وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ إِنِّي لَكُمْ نَذِيرٌ مُّبِينٌ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا اللَّهَ إِنِّي أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ أَلِيمٍ. These two verses are number 25 and 26 of Surah Hud. Allah the Almighty says that we have sent Nuh to his people to tell them that I am indeed a very clear warner to you. I am warning you not to worship other than Allah the Almighty. Because if you do, I'm afraid that you will receive a severe torment, a very painful one. We go all the way from Nuh through Abraham, Moses, Jesus, then finally Muhammad, peace be upon him, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, who sent Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu ta'ala anhu ardah to Yemen. And Yemen was a territory in the peninsula, was occupied mostly by Ahlul Kitab, Jews and Christians, people of the scripture. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam advised Mu'adh ibn Jabal with the following. He said, O Mu'adh, you're going to meet with Ahlul Kitab, with the people of the book. So ud'uhum, call them all to شهادتي أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا رسول الله. This is our belief. Simply to believe that there is no God worthy of worship but Allah, and that Muhammad, peace be upon him, is his messenger, is his last messenger. But this is very known, and it doesn't need any further clarification. Yes, it does. Once I was opening a newspaper, and so some of the stereotyping that the media, Western media, is constantly stereotyping and bashing Muslims and Islam with. A Muslim was offering his prayer. You know that the Prophet, peace be upon him, said that Muslims have been given a quality that no one before them had been given, which is, جُعِلَتْ لِيَ الْأَرْضُ مَسْجِدًا وَطَهُورًا فَأَيُّمَ امْرِئٍ مِّنْ أُمَّتِي أَدْرَكَتْهُ الصَّلَاةَ فَلْيُصَلِّ. That we can pray anywhere as long as it is pure. We don't have to wait until we go to the masjid if we are journeying or traveling. You can pray even in the plane, on the ship, on the highway. You can pull over and start praying as long as you're facing the Qibla. So this person was praying in the street, and while he was praying, a Coca-Cola truck was passing in front of him. So a photographer took a shot while the person is bound down or prostrating himself while the truck was passing by. And the comment was, Muslims worship Coca-Cola. Can you imagine? And believe it or not, there will be people in the West who would buy it. So once they hear about Muslims, they think that they're retarded people, they worship Coke. They're obsessed about the love of Pepsi, Coke, and so on. That's why they pray to the Coca-Cola truck. So it is our duty to make the message very obvious and clear, to lift the fog.